Why is the turn for troops program struck you so personally?
Well, the idea and the initiative is to every lap we complete in the Indy 500, United Rentals donates $100 a lap, and LaSalle Solutions, another partner of ours, has offered up $25. So $125 a lap for us to complete them right now. So obviously you do 200 laps, that's a pretty good amount of money. So the idea is if we can raise, last year we raised just over $100,000. If we can raise $150,000, we can buy an exoskeleton. And that will allow a paralyzed vet to walk again. Well, the next hospital, the VA hospital that needs one, is San Antonio. And the reason we send it to a VA, or the reason they do, is because then multiple people can utilize that and get the benefits of it. But it's just important that we help as much as we can. Obviously, I'm an American, and it's important to me. It's something I value a lot and appreciate the sacrifice they've made. And if we can raise funds, you know, through racing and through some of our partners, it's a great thing. Now, I mean, look, I get a lot of the credit for it, but United Rentals is the one who came up the concept. They pushed it hard. You know, every race that they sponsor, you'll see a big presence of turns for troops. And they don't have to do that. You know, it could just say United Rentals all over the thing, but they like to help back. A great company that's giving back as well. So it's been fun. You know, but I know that at the Grand Prix, we not only completed every lap, but we also sold a lot of the shirts. And the shirts are $35. You can find them here at track right now. We're trying to get them online. You can find them here at track. And all $35 goes to charity. So the cost of the shirts have been covered. So there's been nobody making any money here other than the Turns for Troops group. So, you know, it's a great thing.
You were Sergeant Dan Rose, what does it mean to you to have, like, Graham Rahal and the Turn for Troops program, you know, working not just on your behalf, but on behalf of a lot of guys who have, you know, your challenges?
Well, I mean, it's definitely unexpected and amazing because, you know, like, they have no obligation to do anything like this or, you know, to, like, spread the word about, like, the nonprofits and stuff. So, I mean, the work that they're doing is definitely, you know, helping me out personally, as well as a bunch of other veterans who have, you know, like, spinal cord injuries or TBIs that, you know, probably wouldn't be able to get up and walk without the aid of, you know, the Ekso GT or whatever.
You know, you're paralyzed from the chest down?
Yep.
Yeah. What was it like to get in that exoskeleton?
Well, it was crazy.
In move, yeah.
Yeah, the first time, the first time I actually got in it and stood up, you know, I had been in a chair at that point for, I think, 2.5-3 years, and I totally forgot what 5'7" felt like, you know, and that's not tall by any means, but I felt like I was standing on top of Everest, you know, and I mean, it was just an amazing feeling, and then to be able to, like, take a step, I mean, that blew my mind.
Yeah.
Like, it was awesome.
Where do you think it's going? I mean, where do you think this technology is going ultimately? I mean, in your lifetime, what do you expect to see?
Well, I always joke around that I want to see the rocket boots and the hand blasters, but No, I mean, that's the exciting part. It's like you never know where it's going to go, and I mean, like, the technology is already improving. I think this is the second or third model that the company has put out for, like, their devices, you know, and the battery life is getting better, you know, the more efficient, you know, and I mean, it's just crazy. So I'm excited just to see where, you know, the next 5-10 years, where, you know, like, what we have now is going to look like, you know, that first cell phone everybody had, you know, like, where you could call 10 numbers and that's about it, all it could store.
Yeah.
You know, so I can't wait to see, you know, like, the iPhone or the Android version of the exoskeleton. That'll be an exciting thing to see.